I wanted to say that we have the most beautiful offertory music on the planet.
Yeah.
That is special music, Mark, thank you there. Beautiful. Okay, you guys, I want to talk to you a little bit today about some scripture, all right? In Matthew 3 and 17, this is talking about when Jesus was being baptized, right? And it says, "And lo, a voice from heaven," this would be God the Father, right? "Saying, this is my beloved Son," right? Then there's a comma, and it says, "In whom I'm well pleased." What do you think about that well pleased part? What does that mean to you? You see the unconditional love that came before? "This is my beloved Son." You follow that? See? He loves him, period. Doesn't matter what he does or what he doesn't do. "This is my beloved Son." You capture that? Then the comma. And then it says, "In whom I am well pleased." This morning, the Lord got me up very early. It was 1 o'clock. And I thought, what a blessing. This one cat, she's real old. And she just kind of hangs out at me, you know, like, "Hey, you're up. The food, the dish is empty. We can do this now and nobody knows nothing." And I'm like, "Yeah, but we're not doing this now." Okay? So she comes back at 3 o'clock. And I'm like, "You know, no, 5:30 is your time." Right? So I pet her a little bit and everything's cool. Well, 5:20, the other one is shaking the door. So they're both coming. And now it's time. It's okay, we're gonna get it a little early, da da da. Cats are fed. I love these cats. And I thought, what a beautiful blessing it is that God gives us animals to love. I mean, if you have never loved an animal, you're missing out on things. But anyways, now this part, "in whom I'm well pleased," fed him, was wonderful, but the old cat, my wife says she shouldn't say anything, not this time, but she does anyway. The old cat goes in the box and makes a mess through the kitchen that I got to clean up, right? Because nobody else is up. Now, I still love this cat, right? But I'm not real well pleased at the moment. You follow what I'm saying? It doesn't change my love for that animal. I unconditionally love that animal. The animal is old, and the animal can't help herself anymore. And she does things that we really don't approve of. Okay? But the point of this story is what? What are we talking about here? We're talking about unconditional love, right? Absolutely. It's nice that we please our Heavenly Father. But it's not a condition for His love. He loves you unconditionally. Okay? So don't think you have to be good to be loved. But if you are good, you will well please your Heavenly Father. And I can't think of anything greater than to think that God is smiling upon me. And I hope you think the same way. Would somebody like to pray today? Okay. You're just quick. Go ahead, kid.
Always love us, but for hopefully we'll please you a lot, and then you'll rain down smiles upon us.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.